Hello, what's up YouTube? It's Friday again, and it's been probably nearly a week since last time I filmed a proper video about about topics other than gaming, other than Bible studies, and other than a meetup. But well, I kind of planned to make I kind of have been planning to make this video for a couple of weeks, maybe even for a couple of months, but I actually never got got the chance to to let it crystallize and tried my utmost best to to gather some highly relevant information pertaining to seeking asylum in Australia in year 2000 and in year 2021 and the following year 2022. Since I received a lot of comments on one of my previous videos, in fact search video dates back to almost half a decade ago, and it was filmed in year 2017, and it was published in year 2017, the 31st of March, if my memory still serves, and if YouTube system did not experience any sort of glitches relating to the dating, to the date, of the videos that are hosted on the platform. But in any regard, I just like to talk about the current feasibility of applying for such visa, aka protection visa, protection visa, subclass 866. It's also known as onshore protection visa nowadays, and also back in the days when I actually applied for such visa by I should say I applied for such visa in the past by by mistake, by my grave mistake. And a fair and humble disclaimer here: I am in no wise in encouraging you guys to apply for such visa if you don't actually have met its prescribed criteria, since such visa, as much as I believe it, the Australian government designed such visa, such particular type of subclass of visa to target those who truly either suffered from highly severe, highly degrading persecutions in their home countries, or they do stand a fair chance of being persecuted if they got deported to their home country after their substantive visa expires. I am in no wise encouraging you to apply for that. But instead, this video aims to provide you with information in general, pertaining to such subclass of visa. So before we do so, I just like to go to the let's go to the top, go to the comment section of such video of mine, quite long time ago. So I recently got a comment from Patricia H. I the most recent comment I received on this video came from Patricia H. I beg your pardon if I don't know exactly how to pronounce the name. So please forgive me if I happened to have mispronounced your names, since some of you might have come from countries or regions to which I haven't been. So if you guys can excuse me for that. So but in any regard, let's have a read. So we've got Patricia H. So I'll just abbreviate it. I'll just abbreviate your name as Patricia. If I already withdraw visa 866 in home country, can I apply substantive visa to return to Australia? Well, I'm not sure if you have actually already withdrawn your application for subclass 866 visa, and I'm not sure if you actually already departed from Australia to a third country, either to a third country or back to your home country. Assuming you did, then yes, the simple answer is yes, you can. But since I am not a qualified migration agent nor solicitor, so I give you my advice, my humble advice, well, my humble opinion based solely on my past experience and my current precognitions and preconceptions and also wild speculations derived from some bit of common sense. So you are most likely more likely gonna leave some some records in the database, and such record of your application for a 866 protection visa might just adversely affect your following your future applications for any sort or subclass of substantive visa to stay, to remain in Australia. Yes, and also before we proceed to the next comments, I just like to show you guys a bit of some extra information that I find highly useful for you guys, for you guys, excuse me, to read through, to read it through during your own time at your own pace, and then you can kind of use such sort of information to kind of do a self-assessment, in order to kind of estimate slash speculate your chance of success, your chance of a successful visa grant. So please allow me to direct you to the web, to the web page that I like to show you here. Where did I find? So where is it? Just give me some time so that I can find it. I also need to arrange the let's see. It's actually a case, some sort of a case archive of AEDT, the Administrative Tribunal. Yes. So yes, as you can see, we have Administrative Appeals Tribunal of Australia, and we can see most recent cases, most cited cases, and most assessed cases, or pretty much all over here. And I do happen to have kept some of the earlier cases back in the days, in the years of year 2000 and maybe year 2012, year 2013, all the way to year 2015, as far as I can remember. So why don't we go for a search? Let's search the case. Yes, as you can see, we can click here. Click the specific year here. If you wish to view the the most recent cases, then click 2012. Oh, sorry, then click 2021. Excuse me. Yeah. So as you can see, we have the trustee for Cinderella Trust migration 2021 AATA 327 the 3rd of January 2021. And we have a refugee one, so that might be highly relevant to the main topic of this particular video I am currently filming. So let's click that and have a brief read through. So as you can see, we have a refugee. Oops. Country of reference, China. So we do have a Chinese applicant for protection visa. So the decision is the tribunal confirms the decision to dismiss the application. Oh my God! So this one is actually a case where the tribunal actually dismissed the application, which means probably the applicant made an invalid application. Yeah, so let's have a read. This is an application for review of a decision made by a delegate of the Minister for Immigration on the 27th February 2018 to refuse to grant the visa applicant a protection visa under the Migration Act 1958. On 9th of December 2020, the tribunal dismissed the application under section 426A bracket 1A bracket B of the act, as the applicant did not appear before it to give evidence and present arguments at the time and date of the scheduled hearing. The applicant was notified of the dismissal decision and gave a copy of a written statement setting out the decision and the reasons for the decision in accordance with the section 4 to 6B(5). The applicant was advised that reinstatement of the application could be sought within 14 days of receiving the dismissal statement, and that a failure to apply for reinstatement within the 14-day period would result in confirmation. Would result in confirmation of the dismissal decision. As the applicant did not apply for reinstatement of the application within the 14 days period, the tribunal must affirm the decision to dismiss the application. In these circumstances, the decision under review is taken to be affirmed. So the decision is the tribunal confirms the decision to dismiss the application. Okay. So this one is a failed case. You know, of course, such failure, must belong to the applicant. So let's see, and let's try to find a vastly different case of a different country of origin, probably. We have a Mohammed migration case, division, migration, and refugee division, place of decision, Brisbane. So this one is a It's not exactly a failure. The tribunal remits the application for a student, temporary class TU visa for reconsideration, with the direction that the applicant meets the following criteria for a subclass 500 student visa. So, catch words. Migration and student temporary class TU visa, subclass 500 and student visa, adequate evidence of genuine access to funds provided, decision under review remitted. Okay. So the decision is, let's take a look. The decision, the tribunal remits the applicant for student temporary class TU visa for reconsideration with the direction that the applicant meets the following criteria for a subclass 500 student visa. CL.500.214 of Schedule 2 to the regulations. Okay, so apparently this one is a seems like a successful case with the appeal against the decision putting the applicant's application for a student visa under review, and since AAT perceives and reckons that such applicant meets the criteria for a grant of a student visa. Let's see if we can find any more cases, in regards to 866 protection visa here. Probably there are more, but we can actually search, the database, jurisdiction. Let's see, 866, subclass 866. End of years, end user of pew, so they don't actually have any record pertaining to 866. Visa decisions appeals. That's quite strange. Maybe, but I'm sure I clicked all here. Yeah, all. That's what I clicked. Maybe we can see other cases. We got Mr. Fang Longnian. Place of decision Sydney. Okay, so that's a visitor visa, not a protection visa. Okay. Excuse me. So we got another one. The tribunal remits the application for an employer nomination permanent Class EN visa for reconsideration with the direction that the applicant meets the following criteria for Subclass 186 employer nomination scheme visa. This one is another successful case of appeal, but it is not about protection visa appeal anyway. So it's very rare, you know, for you to to succeed in lodging an appeal against a protection visa's application refusal, as far as I can tell. But I am certain there are more cases, you know. I just can't find them at the moment. Maybe I can find them in the future. Since I did not actually, you know, I don't consider myself that well prepared for making this video. Where is the other case? Let's check year 2020. Let's check that. Year 2020. Yeah, let's go. Yeah, 2020. So what do we have here? Abraham. That's cancellation of the applicant's student visa, subclass 573. That's quite tragic. What else do we have here? Some student visa reconsideration. Not sure if the so many here. Maybe we should search there are a lot of cases here. Oh my god. Tons after tons of cases. Child support. So let's click something by random. Oh, that's another. The tribunal affirms the decision not to grant the applicant a regional employer nomination permanent Class RN visa. Okay. Is there anything else? Other family residence. There don't seem to be any more about protection visa. Maybe we should search. Let's search on 866 visa. Oops. We apologize for the inconvenience to prevent possible abuse of our service. Your ability to connect to Star Page has been suspended at this time. Damn you. so we had to use Google instead. Protection, user, let's see what do we have here. AAT protection user, Supreme Court. Looks like they deleted, you know, most of their cases. Maybe you try some other keywords here. all these searches hasn't been in indexed. Migration Act. Here we have. We have found another case. Let's have a read. Migration regulations. Oops, that's not exactly a case. So it's just you know, the legislations. But well, in any regard, I just like to remind you guys that submitting an application for onshore protection visa while you are still in Australia always counts as the last resort, since submitting such application will first of all, you know, leave an highly adverse and negative impression of yours to the Department of Home Affairs of the Australian government, you know, so the Aussie government will begin to, you know, to think twice about granting you further stays there once you submit such, you know, such application. And even if you do have you know, well-founded fear of persecutions and degrading treatment back in your home country. So I do not consider so doing a wise move, and especially for, you know, for those who are single men, you know, especially for people like us, like I, who consider ourselves MGTOW men going our own ways, and nowadays, you know, pretty much all regimes, they tend to treat MGTOWs single men quite harshly, quite adversely. You know, due to the, you know, mainly due to the fact that we do not actually contribute to their systems, you know, to the perpetuating nature of their systems very much. Since we choose to go our own way, we choose to, you know, to go our own way by remaining single, by not letting ourselves, you know, become indentured servants to feminism, to the gynocentric system, and paying as little taxes as possible, making less than minimum wages. And first of all, if you truly wish to, you know, to migrate to a first world country, then, you know, upskill yourself before so doing. And you must also remain strong and steadfast while so doing, since you can't succeed without patience. You can't succeed without resilience. You can't hold your ground. You can't hold your ground to the end of trials and tribulations without patience, without skill, without a marketable skill, and you won't be able to survive, in the civilized part of this society, the community. Yeah. So, last but not least, applying for a subclass 866, aka protection visa, I'm sure while you are still in Australia, is pretty much, I consider such move pretty much tantamount to simping after the Australian government. Yes, it's pretty much also tantamount to simping after a woman whom you chase, you want to earn her admiration, you want to earn her love, you want to earn her willingness to submit her freshly love, her freshly flesh to you, while you don't actually have the skills, the capabilities to ensnare her without her even knowing. So you can't actually simp after a woman for the sake of being with that woman. It's pretty much the same principle. Yes. Do not ever simp after a government, a regime, even if knowing that you won't get anything in return. We can never expect the other party to reciprocate if they don't actually care about us, right? So we need to have the skill. We need to upskill ourselves. We need to continue to upskill ourselves relentlessly, continuously, constantly, not just on a regular basis, since we don't have currently have that much of a time. Yeah, time is of the essence, and yet we have to do it patiently. It's a subtle skill to remain, even to remain patient during times of tribulations. As simple it may sound, still there are, there are many people who just don't have the patience to wait, to upskill themselves, to endure continuous tribulations and trials and hardships. And so it's, it always saddens me as much as it's motivates me to continue pushing forward with my life. But I can tell you guys with absolute certainty is, that I do not, consider Australia a place of total harmony and, equality and prosperity. Not anymore since the COVID lockdown, some sort of a full scale COVID lockdown, during some waves of surges in infected COVID cases in several states throughout Australia. I know it may sound quite harsh to those of you who have invested so much, in your future plans to get settled, or probably, or at least to work or to study in Australia in the long run. Nevertheless, we all have to take the responsibility, for the choices we are about to make, and for the choices we already made, for the choices that we kind of hesitate to make while we ponder, but overall, I do not recommend you guys to apply for 866 visa just to prolong your stay in Australia or in any other country. I hope I have made my points clear. And just remember, upskill yourselves. Do not simp. Do not even simp after a government. Try to impress them instead of simping after them. Yes? Fair enough. So yeah, I hope this video can help you guys with your future endeavors, with your personal growth, personal development, as well as your life story as a successful and admirable person or character. So thank you very much for watching and listening. I hope you have enjoyed this video overall speaking. But yes, it's time for me to say au revoir again for this filming session, and thank you very much again, and you have a great weekend. So if you do have any other questions, please feel free to write them down below this video. And please consider smashing the like button, and also please consider subscribing to my channel, and also take a look at my Patreon page for some other exclusive contents you will find nowhere else. So yeah, stay tuned, stay faithful, and remain steadfast, and cheers. Au revoir. Goodbye.